Hi Aquarius, I'm Anisha. To know more about my work, you may visit my website www.tarotbyanisha.com. For those of you who are seeking deeper clarity in your personal charts, for a personal consultation, you may write to me at tarotbyanisha@gmail.com. Aquarians, it's quite an exciting and a busy month. We have Mercury that is retrograde most of the month. We have Jupiter that is moving houses from Virgo to Libra for about 13 months. We have a solar eclipse. We have a lunar eclipse and we have Mars that is going direct. We begin the month with a new moon that is there in your house of joint finances, sexuality, intimacy and transformation. And with the new moon over there, it's a time of empowerment. It's a time which is asking you to focus on intimacy as well as developing self-mastery skills. Aquarians, with the new moon over here and this house, besides being a house of joint finances, also speaks about the power struggle that we have with our partners, not just in the personal relationships but also at work. And transformation is the key word over here. You need to be releasing something at this phase of your life, whether it is the way that you think or it's the conditioning that you have had for the longest of time, that you feel that, you know, this is the way, I'm fairly certain this is how I need to be doing things, or it has to be you just being flexible and letting others' perspective also come in and combine along with yours. With this particular phase or with this particular transit, it's a time where your sense of intimacy and sharing also gets heightened, and you can take it either way. Either you can deepen it or it can become a power struggle for you. The big news is that we have Jupiter that is changing signs and it's moving from Virgo to Libra around 10th of September, and this is moving into your house of expansion. This house is all about exploring. It's about expanding beyond the regular experiences in our lives, and the new moon over here may bring some restlessness, some dissatisfaction with the regular routines that are there, and make an effort to initiate new projects or activities that expand your mind. And you need to really free up your mind, Aquarians, for some adventure, some amount of inspiration, to be moving away from the rut that you could be feeling, or even there could be just a sense of that, you know, you've not been able to maybe in a project you've been like stuck forever, and that is just the way, you know, there is no new solution that has been that you have been seeing. But now with Jupiter coming over there, it's just, it'll keep encouraging you, and it's there for 12 months, wherein that you just need to be thinking differently. You need to be not just be more flexible, but you know, so despite the fact that Aquarians are known for their eccentricities, their ability to think outside the box and to be able to be you know, do things which are very unusual and more ahead of their times. But with the Jupiter now in this part of your house, which is about exploring, it's about really opening up your mind to newer possibilities that could possibly be there. You're encouraged to put yourself in situations which would allow such growth to happen, and let that growth happen. Sort of don't get too stuck into your own ways of old ways of doing things. We have a lunar eclipse that is there, and it's there in your house of earned income and self-worth, and it is joining Neptune, and this is a time where it can affect your finances. You could have either just finished paying off a loan or of a debt, or you could have even just sort of you know, finished a mortgage, or you could have finished selling maybe another house that you had, or a larger car that was not required. And it's a time where you could be sort of rebudgeting, looking at your finances, and you could be feeling a little better about it, because there is you know, that money is finally coming to use, and it's not just sort of lying around and you're not doing what to do with it. And this house, because it also rules self-esteem and value, it can be that you could be confronted with feelings about yourself and how it is that you're evaluating yourself and your own worth, and how much you have, you know, materially, and try not to equate that of the value that you have inside you, your own worth of what is it that you bring to the table in life, whether it is with your friendships, whether it's at your work, or whether it is just being you yourself and pushing yourself beyond your own boundaries. And let people also know who you really are, what you've accomplished in life, be it your friends, family, but sort of resist the urge to, of course, rub it in and say that, hey, I've done such a great job in life. And it uses time for, it's a good time for mentoring others as well. You know, share the information readily, be happy to train people, share your skills, share the knowledge that you've accumulated all these years. On 23rd, we have Mercury that is going direct, and it's a brilliant time again, where communication will get smoother. Great time for negotiations, picking up that new job, starting those new projects. And also, if you have to buy another car or a big ticket item, it's a brilliant time for that as well. Around the 24th, we have Venus that is moving into your house of card, your reputation, accolades. And it's also a time where you're going to be, there's going to be heightened sensitivity of how it is that, the world perceives you, and you're going to be very conscious of it. And with Venus being over there, it speaks about almost lucky breaks. You know, you could just break a deal or, get a client who's like really wonderful and just absolutely is supportive of the idea that you're presenting. It can also be working with people who are extremely supportive of you at workplace and completely buy into the idea that you are trying to implement out in the market. And it is a time where it's a time where you will find yourself being extremely committed to whatever it is that you're involved in. Even if it's a relationship, you will find yourself being very, very committed to that particular relationship as well. Around the 28th, we have Mars that is there in your house of behind the scenes activity, and it's a house of research and also the house of confinement to a certain extent. And Mars is joining Pluto over here, and this temporarily frequently creates a sense of ineffectiveness. You know, you may just feel end of the month that I've had too much, I can't do beyond this, I can't push myself. And it's try to not get too overwhelmed with whatever it is that is happening around you. And it's a great time to be seeking therapy as well, for those of you who have been struggling with, maybe there's been too much of an emotional drama that's been happening in your life, or maybe there's just been too much of the work pressure that's been getting to you, and you've not been able to channelize that energy. It's a good time to be seeking therapy, to go into a consultant and heal yourself. And try to, even though there will be a need during this transit to be really assertive and, you know, speak just your mind and be the way that you are. Try not to be too sharp, Aquarius. Be a little softer, be a little gentler, stay flexible, try and see the other person's perspective that is there. And don't sort of rush to do things, you know, don't be impetuous. Let things be a little thought out, be a little planned. They may seem good, but don't get too carried away with it as well. Have a lovely month, Aquarians. It's been a pleasure speaking with you. I'll see you again next month. And thank you so much for watching.